Hi everyone, this is Dr. Rayati. Today we are going to discuss about vector differentiation and vector operations. In this concept of vector differentiation and vector operations, today we are going to discuss about what is the vector differentiation and these vectors, how to change vector differentiation, and also discuss about what is the vector operations. Vector differentiation means, first of all, the function f bar of t is the vector function, and how can change the vector differentiation, and how to solve, can introduce what is the divergence, and what is the curl, what is the gradient, and what is the rotational, and what is the irrotational. Those are the vector operations. Okay, now first I can discuss about what is the definition of vector differentiation. First of all, what is the vector? What is the vector function means? Here, suppose let f bar be a function. Next, here s be the any real number. S be any real number, and t belongs to s, means any scalar, and f bar be also unit vector. F bar be unit vector. Here, the definition of vector means s be any real number, and t bar belongs to s, f bar be unit vector. Then here we have to say that f bar be a vector function, and s be the domain of f bar. This is called the definition of vector. Okay, and also here I bar, j bar, k bar are unit vectors, and also called as dimensionally unit vectors. And these I bar, j bar, k bar unit vectors are applied three-dimensional vector spaces. Here f bar of t, f bar equals to f bar of t. This is the definition of vector function, and also here involving three-dimensional vector space, including we have to write unit vectors I bar, j bar, k bar. Here it is write as f1t I bar plus f2t j bar, f2t j bar plus f3 of t k bar. Okay, this can be written as the vector function in three-dimensional vector spaces. Now I can explain that what is the differentiability of vector function. Here, differentiability of vector function means, suppose here f bar be vector function, and that is right, f bar equals to f bar of t, and also here t belongs to I, sorry, a belongs to I, and this can be written as a limit t tends to a f bar of t minus f bar of a by t minus a. This also can be written as f bar dash of t. Here f bar of dash of t is called a differentiable vector. And this here, now I can explain some of the properties of vector differentiation. Okay, what is the properties of vector differentiation? First property means the constant vector differentiation is zero. First one is the constant vector differentiation means zero. Next, second property means, suppose d by dt of a bar plus or minus b bar, we have to write dA bar by dt plus or minus dB bar by dt. Okay, next of all, write second property dy dt of a bar dot b bar. This can be written as dv bar by dt into a bar plus dot a bar plus d bar by dt dot b bar. Next of all, I can write one of the property means d by dt of a bar cross b bar. This can be written as dv bar by dt a bar plus da bar by dt b bar. Sorry, here cross is there. Here cross is there. Those are the properties of vector differentiation. Next of all, another property is there. Suppose f bar be a vector differentiation function and phi be a any scalar function. That property we have to take here d by dt of f bar into phi. This can be written as d f bar by dt phi bar plus phi plus d phi by dt into f bar. Okay, this is one of the property of vector differentiation. The constant vector differentiation is zero. Next, d by dt of a bar plus or minus b bar is d a bar by dt plus or minus db bar by dt. D by dt of a bar dot b bar equals to db bar by dt dot a bar plus b a bar by dt dot b bar. And d by dt of a bar cross b bar equals to db bar by dt cross a bar plus b a bar by dt cross b bar. Next, d by dt into f bar phi bar. Here f bar be the vector differentiation and phi bar be the scalar differentiation. Those vector differentiation and scalar differentiation property can be written as this d by dt of f bar phi bar phi d f bar by dt into phi bar plus d phi by dt into f bar. And also the vector function, here we have to write the vector function f bar equals to f bar of t, and this can be including unit vectors in three dimensional space. In three dimensional space means we have to write three dimensional coordinates like that. Unit vectors including vector function we have to write. Here write f1 of t into I bar plus f2 of t into j bar plus f3 of t into k bar. Already discuss about this. In this vector function including three dimensional unit vectors, we can arrange vector differentiation. Means here we have to write this df bar by dt equals to df bar by dt. I mean here write df bar and means dt equals to df1 by dt into I bar plus df2 by dt into j bar plus df3 by dt into k bar. Okay, this is the general vector function, and this general vector function including in three dimensional vectors it can arrange in the vector differentiation means this. Okay, those are the properties. Next, tomorrow class I can introduce some more properties and then formulas I can discuss. Okay, thank you.